Welcome everyone. We are passing on to the next phylum under section C, Kingdom Animalia of the syllabus, and here we will be discussing on phylum Platyhelminthes. We'll be looking into the salient features of the phylum, the classification down to classes, and the characteristic features of each of the classes with an example, and as a type species book and phylum Platyhelminthes, we'll be learning in detail on Dedicia. So, what is phylum Platyhelminthes? The phylum gets its name from the two Greek words, that is platus and helminthes, which means flat worms. Okay, so that is how they have got the name Platyhelminthes. It is because they are dorsoventrally flattened. Okay, that is why the name has come, flat worms or Platyhelminthes. So, a Platyhelminthes can be defined as a acellomate, triploblastic, bilaterally symmetrical, vermiform, dorsoventrally flattened organisms. And we can find different kinds of Platyhelminthes. Mostly they are parasitic, and tree living forms are also found. Okay. So when we look into the characters in detail, the general characters in detail, as we have already mentioned, they are triploblastic in the sense their body is derived from three embryonic germ layers, that is ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. They are acellomate, that is they don't have any body cavity, and the spaces between the organs, it is filled with mesenchyma, which is a special what you call mesodermal tissue, but it is not mesodermal cells. Okay, that is why they are acellomate. Okay. Then bilaterally symmetrical in the sense they have their body can be divided into two halves when it is divided, it's cut along the longitudinal axis, and it do have an anterior and posterior ends that is differentiable. Then as already mentioned, they are dorsoventrally flattened, and that is how they have got the name Platyhelminthes, and usually they have a well-defined ventral surface bearing the mouth and gonopus. As we can see, they have an organ system grade of organization. We can say a higher level tissue grade, tissue organ grade of organization here. That is the body cells, they aggregate into definite tissues, and the tissues they make up organs. Okay, so we can see the different organ systems. Fine. Now body is unsegmented except in few in the class Cystoda. We can see that the body is unsegmented, and we can see differently sized organisms. There are microscopic Platyhelminthes, and even some of the Platyhelminthes, they may go for several meters long in size. A majority, they belong to the moderate sized organisms. Then we can see they have adhesive structures like hooks, spines, Bothria, Bothridia, etc. Mostly common in parasitic forms. And regarding the digestive system, it's incomplete or altogether absent. It is absent in Cystoda, and it is present, but it is incomplete and branched in other groups without an anus. Okay, so here you can see if it is, it may be completely absent as in the case of Cystoda, or if it is present, it could be incomplete, branching without anus in other groups. Okay, skeletal, respiratory, circulatory systems are completely lacking, and the excretory organs, it is represented by a pair of tubules and protonephridia with flame cells. In some of the primitive forms of Platyhelminthes, we can see that is these organs are absent. Okay, nervous system, it is represented by a pair of anterior ganglia with a longitudinal nerve cords connected by transverse nerves, and it looks like a ladder, and that is why ladder like nerve system, which we will be looking in detail when we discuss about the Dedicia. Okay, they are mostly monoecious in the sense with well developed you can see they are hermaphrodites. Okay, monoecious, and both the reproductive structures are present in the same organism, and fertilization is internal. Maybe cross-fertilization or self-fertilization. Development is direct or indirect, usually indirect in endoparasites with a complicated life cycle involving many hosts, etc. And they are free-living, commensal and parasitic forms are found. Okay, so that is with regard to the phylum Platyhelminthes. It is divided into three main classes. Phylum Platyhelminthes is divided into three main classes: class 1 Turbellaria, Trematoda, and class Cestoda. Here we have the examples. This is Brugesia. Here it is a liver fluke or fasciola, which you are familiar with. Here you have the tapeworm. Okay, so these are a few of the representatives of phylum Platyhelminthes, and we will be looking into the features of each class as well as one example under each class in the coming videos. Okay.